Hello friends, I am Mrs. Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. Today, I am going to talk about Stack Data Structure and its introduction. The content of today's session are, I'll explain what is Stack, I'll introduce that, I'll explain what the operations can be performed on a stack, as well as their applications. Objective of today's session are, at the end of this session, every learner will be able to understand what is stack, what the operations can be performed on stack, and where it can be used. Let's look at the pictures. It explains there are different stacks are available. The first stack is of books, where the books are kept on each other to form a stack. Another example is of stack of coins, and the last example is of stack of gifts. If we want to access any of the stack, obviously we'll access the first element which is available on top of the stack. This is nothing but the property of the stack. Let's take a look at what is stack. A stack is a linear data structure. In previous session only, I have explained different types of data structure and their explanation. Linear data structure is nothing but a data structure which grows linearly. Stack is one kind of linear data structure. It is a basic data structure where insertion and deletion of items takes place at one end. That end is called as top of the stack. At the single end, the operations can be performed with this data structure, and that single end is called as top of the stack. The basic concept can be illustrated by thinking of your data set as a stack of plates or deck of cards, where you can only take the top of item of the stack in order to remove things from it. Is nothing but a stack. As operations can be performed on single end, then obviously stack will behave like the last inserted element will get deleted first. This property is called as last in first out structure. So on the basis of this property, the stack is also called as last in first out, that is LIFO. Now let's see which operations can be performed on a stack. So the first operation can be performed is nothing but the insertion operation, but the name is given to insertion operation is push operation. While performing every push operation, we need to check whether the space is available in the stack or not by checking the stack is full or not. Other way around, we can say that we are going to check whether the stack is overflowing or not. If it is not, it means the space is available and you can perform a successful push operation. Another operation is pop operation. It means the deletion of data from the stack. Before performing deletion operation, every time we need to check whether the stack is empty or not. If the stack is empty, we can't perform delete operation or a pop operation, as if it is empty, there will not contain any data in the stack. That's why you can't perform the pop operation. This condition is called as underflow condition. The third operation can be performed on a stack is to traverse the contents of the stack. is also called as display operation on the stack. Before displaying the content of stack, every user has to check whether the stack is empty or not. If it is empty, there is no data available for display. And if it is not empty, then display all the content of a stack. Stack can be operated by top pointer, which always points to the element which is available on top of the stack. This is the note that top pointer is used to access all the elements. All these three functions are working with the top pointer variable. And all of us are knowing the operations can be performed on stack at the single end only, and that end is called as top of the stack. Now let's look at how the operations can be performed on a stack. Initially, I'm going to explain that this stack is of size 3, so maximum 3 elements can be stored in the stack. Again, I'm considering this is a stack of type integer and it can hold only the data of type integer. Initially, to indicate that the stack is empty, top is pointed to -1 position. This declaration or this explanation is for sequential data structure, that is an array. I am going to explain this explanation or this stack with respect to array data structure. Means other way round, array is used for the implementation of stack. So initially, top is initialized to -1 to indicate that the stack is empty. Let's perform first push operation onto the stack, means insertion of data. Before performing this insertion operation, you need to update your top to the 0th position and then insert the data. Again, perform a next push operation, update top to the next position and insert the data. Let's see again a push operation, increment your top to next position and then accept the data and push it onto the position 2. Now if again I'll perform a push operation, what will happen? The stack is already full. That's why we can't push the data onto the stack and it will prompt a message, stack is overflow. You can't insert more data into the stack. Let's move forward for next operation, that is pop. Popping is nothing but the deletion of element from a stack. So while popping the element, we need to decrement top by 1 and it seems like deletion of the data from the stack. Again, if I want to perform next pop operation, first of all move top to previous position and then it indicates that the element 20 is deleted from a stack. Now if I want to perform push operation, can I perform? Yes, I can, because there is a space available in the stack. So before pushing the data, top will get incremented by 1. Push data onto the stack and this is the successful push operation. Now let's perform again one more pop operation. For that, top decremented by 1 and the 40 is deleted from the stack. Again perform next pop operation, decrement top by 1. Now top is pointing to -1 position and it indicates that now your stack is empty. Can I perform one more pop operation on the stack? No. As there is no any element available in my stack, it will indicate the error stack is underflow. And these are different operations can be performed on a stack. Now let's see what are the applications of stack. The first well-known example of a stack, application of a stack is reversing the data. While performing reverse operation, we can use of a stack. what we can reverse. The first thing, we can reverse the string. We can reverse the digits of number. We can reverse the result while conversion of number from decimal number system to any another number system, that is binary or octal or hexadecimal number system. The stack can be used while function calls. That may be a simple function call or a recursive function call. In the both cases, the stack can be used. How the stack can be used, that I'll explain in further slide. The next application of a stack is expression conversion, that is conversion of expression from one form to another form. And the next application is expression evaluation. Postfix and prefix type of expressions can be evaluated with the help of stack. Now let's take a glance at a reversing of a string. Let's consider this is the stack and the push operation character by character is performed on a stack. And while popping the elements one by one, with the help of property last in first out, the lastly inserted element D will get pop first, then R, then M, B and I. So the input string is I, B, M, R, D and the output string will be D, R, M, B, I is nothing but the reverse of a string. Let's take a glance at the next example. Is like conversion of number from decimal number system to binary, where consistently we are going to divide or we are going to find out a remainder of a given number by dividing it by 2, as we want to convert it into binary number system. Every time, whatever will be the remainder, that we are going to store in a stack. After performing the operation, we'll perform a pop operation on the remainders, that is onto the stack, and you'll get a result in reverse order. It's nothing but the output or the binary number equivalent to 23. The next example is nothing but the recursion, where the factorial function is used. Very first time, if I want to find out a factorial of number 4, we are going to pass as a 4 to the very first call. And after the first call, we are going to call back again recursively a factorial function by passing the number minus 1, that is 3. And this same task is going to be performed recursively. This will be a second function call. This will be a third function call and this will be a fourth function call. When the result will be 1, we need to return back and it will return back and will calculate the 2 into factorial 1. It will return back with the value 2. Here it will return back with the value 6 and at the end it will give the result 24 is nothing but the factorial of 4. Here every time, every function call, it utilizes a stack. And this stack is not designed by the user or a programmer. That's why this stack is called as implicit stack. Whatever we have done in previous two examples, this stack is designed by the user. That's why these type of stacks are called as explicit stacks. And the stack used by the function call, that may be a simple function call or a recursive function call, this stack is called as implicit stack. The rest of two operations or application of a stack are expression conversion and expression evaluation. I'll explain both of the things in separate videos. Thank you so much.